Welcome to week three of Reading Patriot Team Football. I'm back here, Joe.
Tim, welcome back. We missed you.
International trip. I was over at the Dublin Irish Football Championship. Sky Sports had me brought over there.
I was paid
handsomely over there
to do it.
Hey, the Rockets are off to a great start this season, sitting 2-0 after beating perennial powerhouse Everett on the Crimson Tide's home field at that. You know, now short of the execution of the play last week, the Rockets showed some real mettle by accepting to play Everett on short notice. I remember our sons commenting after the team weigh-in that that Everett team is one of the biggest teams I've ever seen. And so with a performance like that, I think the Rockets are feeling they could play with anyone in the state. But
it was an impressive win, Tim. Very good defensively. They moved the ball well. It was a good one.
Nice. As the captains go out, up next is North Middlesex with their Boise State Cowboys uniforms. Are they Cowboys?
I think Boise they are State? The Cowboys.
Last year, this team easily handled the B team from North Middlesex, but their C team, which our B team just found out was a powerhouse, and their A team was very good too. So depending on who are older lighters and there's some freshmen that are coming down playing this team was very, very well coached last year too. So they're a big bunch over there coming out of Leominster area. And the Rockets are going to have their hands full here again today. So up next is the Reading Rockets versus North Middlesex. Rockets getting fired up right here. Beautiful day. A little windy up here, Joe.
A little breezy. Just a little touch of fall.
We're in the shade, too. So if you don't mind, I'm probably going to hold you a little bit later
on.
It's freezing.
It's all right. I'm not that cold.
Oh, okay. Just checking. Hey, all bets are on when it gets cold up here, Joe.
All right,
looks like the Rockets are going to be kicking off to North Middlesex here to start the game, left to right. All right, looks like Lucas Fleming, number 24, back to kick for the Rockets. He's 23 this year.
He's 23.
He was 24 last year. My steel trap of a memory remembers that. Here's the kick. It's a good one. It looks like it may bounce. It's going to stay in bounds here. Gets picked up, and I think he stepped out of bounds right there, and he did. So great kick and excellent field position for it. Gets down just about to the 12-yard line. That pushes him back
pretty
deep. So excellent field position for the Rocket D, and let's see what they have to start.
Yeah.
All right, here we go. First and 10 here for North Middlesex. I saw this. Number 59 and 51 of their skill position backs set up in the eye.
They look like a large team. Swarming defense.
Handoff left. Oh, big tackle right there through the middle. Number 32 was Dominic DiCrescenzo, and he stuffs him for a loss. Big Dom. We got a little player profile set for him later.
Dom's we'll get him.
He's one of the returning players from last year's A squad, and he's a big dude, and he can move. So he busted right through the middle and pushed him back and up 5 yards.
Dom had a good one last week, too, Tim.
Nice. Here we go. Call it second and about 12. After the 2-yard pushback, same formation, hand up right up the middle, number 59. It's got some room, but he gets stacked up quickly, too. Let's see who's in on that one.
I see
number 11, and there was Troy Pollock in there.
Might have been Sean Beckenhouse as well.
I call him Becken Hughes, but that's only because that's his name.
Okay.
You know what I'm saying? Okay.
And I've been doing it wrong for 2 weeks.
He hits
Tim.
Like
that's
a house.
That's why we need you around here.
Yeah.
He hits like a house.
Hey, poor Evan Tice's name was butchered last week, too.
Was it? Oh,
yeah.
Okay.
You know, Thies.
Thies.
Yeah. So we'll say sorry to the Tice family in advance. So it looks like it's going to be right back to the original line of scrimmage. It's going to be 3rd and 10 here. This is a big play for the Rockets because the field position's in their favor.
Establish yourself early. Key.
That front line's been strong so far this year, too. Oh, it's a keeper. He's rolling out. He's going to throw the ball, and he's got it. Oh, he's got a guy open. He pulls it down for the first down. Wow. Very, very good coverage, too, there. Number 73 was Patrick Duras covering him. He's all over him. And number 43 pulls in it for a first down. So that's a huge play on 3rd and 10 for North Middlesex to move the chains.
That's good. It's a good sign, though, Tim. We made him throw on 3rd and long. And two bad things happen when you throw the ball, right? Had the one good one go there.
Yeah, good play right there by number 43 because Patrick Duras had excellent coverage on him. Here for North Middlesex at about the 25-yard line. Inside handoff right there. He gets stacked up immediately. I think DiCrescenzo might have been in there again.
Stout defense up the middle.
Yep. Danny O'Connor in there, number 54. Close to my own heart there, right? Number 24, Lucas Lorenzo in there, too. So it's going to be 2nd and 8 upcoming. Here we go. It's going to be 2nd and 8 here for North Middlesex. Tightly stacked formation. Inside handoff right there. Cut off. Oh, almost right there. He's got a huge hole there. 43. Wow. Nice play taking him down there at the end. His number 84 was Evan Tice right there. But what a play. It looked like Sean Beckenhuis had a bead on him early behind the line of scrimmage. And he made a quick, nifty move there to break it. And he had daylight ahead of him. So the speedy Tice, who's probably the lightest player on our team, too, barely getting on this A team, actually, tracks him down from behind and saves even a bigger run. So huge play on second down. It's first and 10, and we're into Rocket territory now.
Okay.
All right, first and 10 here. Rocket side of the ball. Well, the field, I mean, right up the middle, right at the gut. He's got room number 24. He gets caught from behind again right there. Number 22, Dan Damari in there. Number 11, Troy Pollock for the stop, but it's another big gainer on first down. And, you know, this big, tough line for Reading, a couple plays right there just got pushed around.
All of a sudden, Tim, started well. Let's see if they can bounce back.
You got big Jay Kajander in there, Lucas Lorenza, Danny O'Connor on that front line, Lucas Fleming as well. And those guys have been tough the last few games, but a couple runs in a row right up the gut for success for North Middlesex. So another first down inside the 40. Stacked heavy right formation. It's a keeper up the middle. 51's got a lot of room. He's still on his feet. Another big gain right off the gut there. He's still on his feet.
Whistle. All right.
Finally push him back. He didn't want to go down. 51. Sean Beckenhuis in on there and Troy Pollock as well, but another big gain on first down. Go, it's second and call it four right here. Big Dave Lynch goes in there for Oki. Handoff up the middle and right there gets stacked up, and that's Dom DiCrescenzo for a loss. So big Dom, he comes in again like he did in the first play of the game. Nice stop up the middle, closing that hole in the middle, and Lynch, he got himself in there too, number 10. So it's going to be third and push back about a foot, third and four and a half. Big third down play here, but I would imagine that this is four down territory here.
I would imagine, Tim.
Hand off at the middle. Oh, he's hit immediately by DiCrescenzo again. Hit for a loss. He spun off. Nice 43 spun off. That's a kid who made the great first down catch. Almost got away from him, but Dom grabbed his shirt and says no more. Pushes him back 2 yards, and now we get a fourth and five going. And you're going to see him go for it here, this type of field position. So very, very big play right here for the Rockets.
See, Pat Duras done a great job in coverage. I'd like to see a pickoff by him. He's covered that kid in Everett last week very, very well.
Big, huge play right here for the Rockets. They'd love to get the ball back. 4 minutes to go in the first quarter. He is going to roll out to throw again. He's wide open. Oh, it's tipped it, and it's incomplete. Beautiful. Put a little too much mustard on that one underneath. And he had his guy open, too. So that was a well-constructed play. They just didn't execute. And here comes the Rocket offense. So beautiful stop after some pretty good movement right there for North Middlesex with some great plays. We had him pinned deep, you know, and a huge third down play to keep it going. A couple more has moved it down to the Rockets' 34-yard line. And that's where they're going to take over. And big Lucas Fleming is coming in. He'll look like he's going to be calling the plays here, number 23. Looks like we have Fleming and DiCrescenzo in the backfield. Direct snap to Lucas. He follows Big Dom. Gets stacked up quick, but he drives it for about three or four tough yards. That's a big guy to follow, Dom DiCrescenzo.
It's a lot.
And a big guy following him in Fleming. So you may see a little bit of that smash mouth football with those big guys here today. So call it a gain of about three, second and seven coming up. Second and seven right here for the Rockets. Same setup, Fleming, DiCrescenzo in the backfield. Looks like we got some movement. Might push the Rockets back 5 yards here, and it does. So we're going to replay second down, make it second and 12 upcoming. Look for us to see the same play here. Split far right, Pat Dwyer. Direct snap goes to DiCrescenzo. This time he busts outside, breaks off a tackle, gets hit by a couple guys. He doesn't want to go down. Dominic drives that to about the 40-yard line. So he gets about maybe eight or nine back there. and it's going to be
scheduled, Tim.
It's going to be third and call it three here, maybe three and a half. So this will be a big play here. Nice run by Dom DiCrescenzo right there to get some of that back. And big play here, third down. Danny Demari checks into the game. As well as number 20, Brendan Fox is in there. In the backfield, looks like Fleming. Direct snap to Demari. He falls. Fleming spins off. He's getting stacked up there, and I don't think he has it. So it's going to be fourth down. He's very close, actually. I'd be fourth down in a yard here. It's going to be an interesting call here for the Rockets. Call it fourth and one and a half, and let's see what the coaching staff's going to do here. Wow, big play here. They're bringing back in Big Dom DiCrescenzo and Fleming in the backfield. The two bulls.
This is the weight back there.
And this is a huge play right here. They need one and a half to keep the chains moving here. Direct snap to Dom. He takes it, puts his head down. He's got it. Oh, he's got it to Moore. He's a big dude up there, and he drives it for five or six. So great play to DiCrescenzo for the first down. The chains moving. We're just about out to midfield. You know, getting back to Domi, you know, number 32, he's one of our returning Patriot team members. He's a beast, 190 pounds. He's one of easily the biggest dudes on the team. He's got great athleticism, too. We asked the kids a bunch of survey questions. We said, who would you like to be, see president, except for one who's actually running? Tom Brady is Dom's guy. We'll come back to player profile and Dom coming up. First down, direct snap to Troy Pollack. He follows Fleming, and Pollack's got room on the outside, and he's not going to be beat. What a run by Troy Pollack. First time he touches the ball, he follows Fleming, cuts outside, and he has got wheels. And I'll tell you right now, Troy Pollack's speed overcomes the fact that he's one of the smaller guys out here, and he is beating some big dudes. He busted it outside, and he saw daylight ahead of him and ripped that thing for a 50-yard-plus touchdown. Huge play by Pollack with a minute to go here in the first. And here come the Rockets here for the extra. Rockets break the huddle here for two. Looks like they're going for one, I mean, under here. Troy Pollack under center. Back deep. It's going to be a hand. Oh, he's going to keep it himself, and he's going to take it in himself, too. Untouched. I like that read option right there for Pollack. Gives him the option to throw the ball or run it, and he runs it in there. Great sort of naked bootleg there. He runs it in for 2 points. I think it actually counts as one as a run here.
It counts as one.
I'm not going to trust our scoreboard over there. But I will talk to them right now. But that looks like it's going to be the end of the quarter. And a great series for the Rockets. Really risky play on fourth down to make it happen. And then Troy Pollack, first time he touches a ball, rips one off for 50-plus yards and then takes in the extra. You know, getting back to Domi DiCrescenzo, right? His favorite female celebrity, Joe? Ronda Rousey. You like her?
Yeah.
I bet you'd like to be put in a chokehold by her, huh?
Hey, it wouldn't be hard.
She once submitted an opponent in 14 seconds, Joe.
Yeah.
I don't think it'd take that long with you, huh?
No.
Yeah,
I would give in.
All she'd have to do is ask.
That's right.
Dom's favorite food is gnocchi. I bet you he can eat a pound of that stuff.
2 pounds.
So I had this Trader Joe's gnocchi once, frozen stuff. It was the greatest thing I've ever had in my life.
Now, introduce that to Dom. He'd get
bigger.
Oh,
my gosh. Yeah, Trader Joe's gnocchi. The meal portion he had, he'd have to eat about seven of them. But here we go. The Rockets are going to be kicking off here after the touchdown. Lucas Fleming back. Nice boot there. Touch it. Nicely picked up by number 40 here. Oh, he's got some room. 59. 59 is a good player for those guys. He's one of their skill position backs. And right in there was number 9, Jay Kajander. Also in there, number 52 was in there, was Mason Dion. And you know what? I was talking to Dan earlier. I said, Dan, who are the guys who have stepped it up, really surprised you? You get to this A division, and you see some kids who really come into their own this year. He says, Mason Dion's a beast. He stepped it up big time. Pat DeRoss is another one that's really opening eyes this year.
He's had very good games.
And Foxy's first-year player, Brendan Fox.
Don't be fooled.
Little
He's
guy
not a big
who's
guy.
Powerful. Here we go, first and 10 here from their own 45, North Middlesex. Handoff right up the gut. He gets stacked up immediately. Let's see who is in on that play.
Whatever worked for Northern Middlesex earlier.
Pulling them up there, right there, Dan. He's O'Connor not. In there. I noticed, yeah, I told Dan, wear green gloves going out so I can actually see you on the play. So Danny Oak in there on a nice play, and Dom DiCrescenzo in there to help him. So for no gain, it's going to be 2nd and 9 coming up. All right, here we go. 2nd and 10, maybe pushed back a little bit, right at the same spot here after the nice stop by Oki. I formation. He hands it right up. They got there. Oh, what a play right up the middle. That's Oki again. Bust the middle. He stops him down low, and in comes DiCrescenzo up high. So nice play by Oak to get through the line. Hits him behind the line of scrimmage. That's 2 in a row for my boy.
He's in there. Huh? He's in there. That's the key. Slow him down. Then get some help.
I think he found out I was coming back. This was my first game back, and I said, it's time to step it up, son.
No, he had some good ones.
Nice play by Oak to get in the backfield. Great penetration, and DiCrescenzo over the top to clinch it. It's now 3rd and long, 3rd and 13. Looks like a clear passing down here. They're spread 2 right, 1 left, and he's going back to throw. Throws it underneath. Nice play. Oh, boy. He hits it, and who comes in but number 11, Troy Pollock, times it perfectly. Got his hands on it. Looked like he was going to make the play, and Pollock puts a stick on him. Oki and Pollock jumping up and down like they just, it's Christmas morning out there, but it's 4th down here. And you might see these guys go for it here again, too, but this is a risky play here with, you know,
I see a guy
Rockets going for 4th, and yeah, he's dropping back the kick here, so that's probably the smart play here.
Watch the fake, though.
Back deep will be Pollock. It's a kick, and it's a pretty good one. Good kick. Troy's going to take this thing and feel. He fields it at the 20. Cuts behind one blocker, another. Cuts up. He's still on his feet, but nice tackle right there. He tried to follow number 44 with Steve Needham. Get a little bit of confusion for following that block, but the Rockets are going to take over here at their own 29-yard line after a great defensive stand, including a couple nice plays by Oki. All right, 1st down here for the Rockets. Take over after a great. That's the defense we were talking about, right, Joe? The ones that really knocked Everett around.
Yeah, it's swarming. They come from all over, Tim. Good athleticism.
Direct snap to Fleming. Nice job with Lucas Turner. Did you see the hand work right there?
Moving it to the outside.
I'm going to
no
tell
fumbles.
You right now, this is something that Lucas clearly has worked on, right? Lucas gets knocked out after a big game, but Lucas was a guy who last year held the ball out a little bit too much, right? And we were suffering a little bit with that one because he lost the ball a couple times. Clearly well coached here about changing that ball to the outside and protecting it. Unfortunately, there's a flag here, and I see Coach Pollock just throwing his hands up in the air. Can't believe it. And it looks like the ball's going to come back. I don't know if they're going to pull the whole play back or it was something that happened at the end.
I think it was after the play, Tim, yeah. But moving from the spot, so it looks like from the spot, keep the ball.
Looks like it's still going to be a first down, but it's going to move the Rockets back almost 15 yards. Might have been after the play. Probably an unnecessary roughness after the play there. But what a nice run by Fleming and beautiful ball handling skills right there, and he's clearly been working on it. He looked like Earl Campbell on that one.
Well, he's got the speed. He's got the size. He's
1st and 10 from the 40 right here. We got Dominic and I think that might be Dan Damari right there. Diz Damari, he sees the hole, and he hits it very quickly for a quick 3 or 4. So Damari's got the instincts when he sees that hole, both offensively and defensively, and he's quick. So Danny takes that for 4 yards. It's going to be 2nd and 6 coming up. All right, here we go. 2nd and 6 right now for the Rockets. We got DiCrescenzo and Pollock back. Coach has them switch spots here. Look for the direct snap to Pollock. No, it goes to DiCrescenzo. You don't see that. Oh, Domi puts his head down and drives it for about 3 or 4. That's an odd one, having Troy be the lead blocker, right, instead of the other way around.
Would you want to tackle DiCrescenzo?
Listen, they don't want to see him without a blocker. They don't
That's
want to
right.
see him with a blocker. That was an interesting one with Troy being the lead blocker. On that one, it's going to be 3rd and about 4 upcoming. Rockets break the huddle. Split right, number 71, Pat Dwyer. Speedster at the top of the field there, right, Joe?
Take after his father.
That's right. Pollock DiCrescenzo goes to Pollock this time. That's a little bit more traditional. He busts outside. Troy's going to get strung. Oh, he stays at his feet, and I think he got the 1st down. Wow. He is a tough runner, and you know what? He knew exactly where that 1st down marker was, Joe, didn't
smart.
He?
Yeah, there it goes.
He's a guy who looked at it, he knew what he needed. 1st down right there for the Rockets. And out comes He switches up the whole offensive line right here. 6:29 to go in the half. The Rockets are up 7-0. They're at the 50-yard line upcoming. All right, hey, first and 10 here from midfield for the Rockets. Whole new offensive line in there. Different look right here, too. We had a motion right there, number 81. I think that's a handoff up the middle to Damari. He's still on his feet. Damari takes it for four with Zach Kenyon, who's in motion across there. And second down upcoming.
Better at half.
Here we go. Second and call it, just say six right here. Totally different setup here. A couple guys split left. See, Jonathan Grady split way to left. That looks like Kenyon in motion again. Oh, it falls in the ground. And that could be a tough one. I know who got it. Wow, great play to pounce on that ball was Pollock. They mishandled the handoff there. I think that might have been between Pollock and Kenyon. I'm not sure. I couldn't see the numbers there, but mishandled it. Drops it about 5-yard loss, but Rockets fortunate enough to get that one. So Troy has a presence of mind to pounce on it. And we got third and 9 coming up here.
Again, I think we might be in four down territory at midfield here, Tim.
I would think so. You know, especially with the wind going this way, Joe. The wind is kicking right into the Rockets' face, so the net gain on a punt might be low here. Split left is Grady. Split left is also Stevie Needham. Could be a passing down here. There goes Kenyon in motion. Handoff up the middle. Oh, it's a keeper for Troy. Look at the hole he's got. Oh, they got a flag on him here. He's got a huge gain here for a first down and more. But there's a flag down, and this one may be coming back. We'll see. It's a hold right there, and let's see what the hold is on the Rockets. I didn't see who was the culprit there, but it looked like it wasn't anywhere near the play in any event. Beautiful counter there for Troy. He rips it off for what is a first down, and they're going to be playing third down again. So Rockets snake bit with a couple of penalties. Wow, the hold pushes the Rockets back to third and call it 20. That's a tough one, too, because Troy had a beautiful counter play there. He had a ton of daylight for a first down, so that's a big, big swing right there. Two split far right. It's going to be a throw out front there to Stevie Needham. Needham cuts it up, but he gets met almost immediately behind the line of scrimmage, so nice job by North Middlesex to snuff that one out. It's going to be fourth down here, and you may see the guys kick here, but like you said, that wind is right in their face. He's calling for a red offense, and we'll see what the coaching staff has in plan here. Fourth down here. Rockets, all right, looks like Troy is going back, and he may be kicking this thing. Sometimes you see in a play like this that you'd actually air it out for a big long pass because you don't mind if they even kick it. That's a nice kick by Troy. Field at about the 40, cuts left and right. Very slippery move at the middle. He gets absolutely he's still on his feet. He got hit by DeCrescenzo, and he bounced off him. Wow, and he gets taken down by the punter. He came out of that pile, Joe. I didn't know how he did it.
Dormy
DeCrescenzo put the lick on him. He spun off it. That's number 43 who made that great catch earlier. That kid is an athlete, my friend. And that one hurt right there. Huge, huge run back for North Middlesex. And it looks like Troy's a little bit shaken up on that play. You know, earlier, it looks like Lucas got his ankle shaken up on that play where he had the big gainer here that they had the penalty on. So it looks like we got a timeout right here for the Rockets. While we have a timeout, number 9 is our returning Patriot player, Jay Kajander. Jay's favorite food is chicken. Sort of like saying your favorite ice cream is vanilla, right?
Right.
Chicken flavored everything. His funniest movie, Happy Gilmore. That was funny, huh? Now get this, we asked the kids to pick a song to help them get the team pumped up. Jay's pick, Scourge of Iron.
Never heard of it.
Yeah, by death metal band, Cannibal Corpse.
Nice.
You know, how about that? You a big Cannibal Corpse fan?
No, it's way after me, Tim.
We also asked him to make the choice for president, and he picked George Fisher. You know who that is?
No, I don't.
Lead singer of Cannibal Corpse, of course.
Well,
right?
I should have known that.
Listen, give it our choice in November. I think Jay's on to something
here. You know what? You're right.
Why not the lead singer of a death metal band for POTUS, right?
Why not?
So Jay's a returning guy, and he's been a big part of that defensive line. And apparently a massive death metal fan, Jay.
Everybody gets a vote.
Takes
then.
All types, my friends. Takes all types. I like it. Here we go. It's going to be first down for North Middlesex from inside the Rocket 25 after the really spectacular run back by 43. He fooled us all.
Yeah, I thought
Crescenzo came in and put a lick on him. He spun out of it. I have to look at that tape. Pitch out left. Looks like Kajandra is actually getting held right there. And there's a flag from the exact opposite side. I saw our boy number 9, Jay, look like he had a hold on him. And that flag, I don't know if you saw the same thing I did, but that flag came in from way over the other side. And there is a hold. It's going to push him back. So that guy must have x-ray vision, the guy who threw the flag. But I thought the hold was actually on Kajandra, who had some good pressure. See what happens when we do a profile? Next thing you know, you're in on the play.
You pumped him up, Tim. It was the heavy metal that pumped him up.
I think it's key to separate the genres of heavy metal and death metal.
Death metal.
You know what I mean?
All right.
As well as speed metal.
I wouldn't know the difference, to be honest with you.
If you listen to the Scourge of Iron song, you know that it's actually not a speed metal song.
I will make it a point to do that.
But it's very, very most definitely
Spotify
death metal.
Tonight.
All right, here we go. It's going to be 1st and 20 right now after the penalty. Stacked very heavily right here. Handed off right up the gut. Oh, he gets met by, let's see, 24 was Lucas. In there, gets pushed back. Number 72. Who is that? Is that 72? 73? That was Pat Duross.
That's his end.
Pat Duross came in on there, but he got slowed down by Lucas Lorenzo, number 24 up the middle. He spun around. He starts running backwards, and Duross ran him down.
Again, that swarming defense.
Patrick looking a lot like his older brother Colin. These guys hit the A-team, and all of a sudden they run like gazelles. Because I know Paul's one of the slowest guys I've ever seen in my life, his father.
I've never seen him run. He's that slow.
Yeah, it's unbelievable. So here we are, 2nd, and now it's 2nd and forever right here. So North Middlesex going the wrong direction. Back to the I formation here. It's going to be a throw. He's got them wide open here, number 43, and he makes the catch. Beautiful play. Troy's on him. He pushes him down, but that play was set up early, and number 43 is a player, isn't he? But he was wide open from the get-go, and that's going to be a huge first down for North Middlesex down to the 10-yard line here. And this is a heck of a game here, Joe. 7-0 with a minute 30 to go in the half. This is a huge opportunity for North Middlesex. We'll see what the Rocket D can do.
Here,
that pack right there is our nose tackle, Lucas Lorenza. We have two Lucases on the team, Lucas Fleming and Lorenza. So the coaches have been taking a call on Lorenza, Larry.
Okay.
You know, who are the most famous Larrys you know, Joe?
Larry Costello? Yeah, he's a friend of mine. I don't know, he's not famous, Joe. No, he isn't.
How about Larry Bird?
Larry Bird.
Yeah? Any other Larrys? Larry David? He's funny.
He's funny.
You know, how about my personal favorite? Larry Fine. Right?
Larry's
Three Stooges?
Fine. Oh, that's
Three
the
Stooges?
One
Come on.
Of.
All right, here we go. It's 1:31 to go. It's a first down here. Just not first and goal quite, but just outside the 10. I formation. It's going to be a throw right here. He throws it over the head. Oh, intercepted! What a play right there by number 84, Evan Tice. He threw it a little bit behind there, and Tice comes in and picks it up. He's all over. He looks like Malcolm Butler on that one. And Tice sniffs it out, and there's a guy right there, Evan Tice. You want to talk about speed overcoming size. He's one of the smallest guys on this team. He barely made weight at 110 to get on this Patriot team. And he's made two huge plays today. Made a huge play tackling a guy who's on a busted play. And now Tice does the interception here. And I think they're content to run that clock out right now. So at halftime, huge play by Tice. And it's the Rockets 7 and North Middlesex 0. Let's get back to number 24, Lukey Lorenza here, if we can find him. He's right here next to the water jug, Joe, right? Right next to Damari. So Lucas, right? Talk about famous Larrys, right? You remember Larry Fine, right?
I've heard the name, yes.
What, the Three Stooges,
Three
Joe?
Stooges,
that's
yes.
Larry
that's
Fine.
Before my time, Tim.
Joe, there's not much on this earth that's before your time. All right, so listen. My sister Katie Miller has the same exact hair as Larry Fine. So I just wanted to say that. That's for Katie. Lucas's favorite food, chicken parm and ice cream.
It's a good combination. Together?
This is exactly what I just said in my notes here. What do you mean, together?
Did you put the ice cream on the chicken parm?
Well, yeah. Listen, this is the type of cutting edge, insight that we got to get into. I'll have to pull Lucas aside here.
Okay,
his favorite male celebrity, John Cena, WWE superstar. Favorite funniest movie, Step Brothers. And you know who Lucas's choice for president would be? Coach Richie Marshallsey.
That's a good choice.
True story.
Grandpa,
true story.
Right? Isn't he a new grandfather?
He is a new grandfather. Yeah. It's Coach Marshallsey right there, right by the 50-yard line, right?
Yeah.
I'm playing him right now in my fantasy football.
Yeah, I heard he's
I'm getting walloped right now there. But you know what?
Okay.
Hey, speak about a choice for president that could make Donald Trump seem reasonable, huh? Coach Richie?
Exactly.
All right, hey, I'm going to take this time at halftime to remind anyone who gets a chance to watch this before it gets aired next week. Pop Warner Social coming up next Saturday night at Meadowbrook. Some good friends of mine, Bed by Nine, the band. Awesome. Really good, Joe. So, hey, at halftime, Rockets 7, North Middlesex 0. We'll see you in the second half. All right, start of the second half here. Long break in between there, Joe. We get to check our fantasy scores, eat some lunch. All right, here's the kickoff. Back deep is Damari is back. Oh, that looks like almost an onside kick. That ball is live right there. They got to jump on it. All right, he does jump on it over there in the corner. Number 84 is Pat Duros there, but goes 10 yards. That thing's live. It didn't look like anyone had a sense of urgency, certainly not from the North Middlesex side. So the Rockets are going to take over here, first and 10 from just about their 40-yard line. And big loss on the sidelines right now for the second half. Number 23, Lucas Fleming, had wrenched his ankle on that play where he had the big run. We were praising him about the ball-handling move.
Right.
And he got rolled out of the sidelines, and he is out right now. So that's a big loss for the Rockets, who like to switch it up with that ground-and-pound Fleming DiCrescenzo offense and then sort of the spread offense with Pollock.
Which one they're out here now.
So Pollock's out there right now. We got Jonathan Grady out right. Number 81, Zach Kenyon, split left. Goes to Pollock. Oh, he's going to keep it himself. He's going to try to throw it. Oh, good play right there. Pollock almost snuck away, but big number 7. He had his hands in the air. Pollock looked like he had two guys going down there, Grady, and underneath was Pat Duros, but number 7, he got his hands in the air, and Troy had to pull it down, and they push him back for a loss. All right, here we go. Second and call at 15 now after the pushback. Troy tried to pull it down, and he's usually shifty there, but he got swarmed under North Middlesex there. Two guys split right. In motions Kenyon. It's a handoff right here. It looks like, it's a keeper. That same play. Oh, my gosh, look at Troy go. That same exact play that they called back for the thing. Troy takes it himself. And that's that counter move. It's the push off to Damari Wright. He keeps it himself.
And no flags, Tim.
Absolutely no flags. And I'll tell you, man, little guy who is actually running away from the defensive backfield. What a play by Pollock on that one right there. He fooled us on the play. It was a play to Damari, and he has the option there. Hand it to Damari or take it himself. Massive hole. He finds a seam and rips it off for, I'm going to say.
62, Tim.
60. Well, you see where the two is right there.
Oh,
let's
more
call
money.
It there.
Yeah,
more money.
67,
68 yard touchdown by Troy. He's got to come off for oxygen. He touches the ball three times. He's running 50, 60 yards.
Now, that would be you and me, Tim. He's in good shape.
I'm actually tired calling that thing right now. That was outstanding. What a play by Troy. That play worked well twice. The first one they took back for a big penalty, and that one, no flags in the play, and Pollock. They don't have an answer for him. In motions Needham. It's going to be Pollock keeping himself, and he's in. Wow. He is shifty. You know what's funny, too? That big offensive line, too. You get some of those tall guys there. Troy's a tough guy to pick up behind there.
Yeah.
And he's too quick, Joe. He's
exactly.
Too quick to go left or right. You don't know which hole he's going through. And Troy made an unbelievable play right there for his second very long touchdown here. That gives some nice breathing room, too, because this thing was tight.
Just play some good defense here in.
14-0 Rockets with 8:41 to go. Why don't we see if we get some of our cheerleaders over here. Not cheering at the point, but these are the guys, the girls here for the A-team. And you know what we'll do one time during the season, Joe? We'll get the girls up here to introduce themselves.
That'd be a good
but
thing.
But the A-team squad is out there today cheering on the Rockets, and they just had something to cheer about there with Pollock. What a run to make it 14-0. He keeps the extra point himself, and I see some smiles in the faces of the coaches there, but there's a long way to go in this one, and clearly North Middlesex has the skill position players to bust one, and one of them, number 43, is back deep right now, 43 and 99. It looks like
Brendan Fox?
Looks like number 20, Foxy, is back there taking over the duties for Lucas Fleming, so let's see what we got here. Let's see what Foxy can do. Nice boot by Foxy right up the middle. Field it at the 25-yard line. 99's going to seam, and there you go. This is exactly what I talked about. They got the skill position, the players to do it. Oh, but Troy takes him. Oh, he stays on his feet. Troy almost does it, but that's exactly what we just talked about, Joe. What an answer. He saw a seam, went right up the gut, and I'll tell you, that's got to have something that the coaches are going to go crazy about guys not staying in their lanes.
Stay focused.
Have to take a look at the film on that, but the lanes up the middle, it was one wide open, and big number 99 rambled. Troy almost tripped him up at the end, and how about that for an answer? Right back in it, and we'll see if they're going to try to kick here to make it a two-point conversion, or are they going to go for the one? And they're going for the two, which could be a huge play right here for the kick.
Very far back, Tim. Giving themselves room to get it over the line.
Big, huge play right here. And he boots it, and that is
wide.
No good. Woo, he had the distance power. He pulled it just a little bit. And that one may come back to haunt North Middlesex because that two-point conversion, now they need a score and a two-pointer to get back into this game to tie it up. But wow, I told you they had the skill position players there, and that was a very quick answer to Troy's touchdown. We'll be back. Hey, number 33 is coach's son, Joe Gilligan. Awesome Joe, what
awesome call him. Joe.
He's a classic of large proportions. Very personal, funny kid, isn't he?
Oh.
He's also a Ronda Rousey fan. His funniest movie, The Sandlot. Isn't that a classic?
That is a good one.
Oh, yeah. Michael Squints Palidoris. Yeah, he made fake drowning into an art form, didn't he? Remember that one?
Yes, he did.
Remember the most famous quote of that one?
I don't know.
You're killing me, Smalls. Right? That one's taking on some pop culture reference here. His favorite food, pizza. Who doesn't love pizza? Listen, there's a major shift in the pizza thing in Reading. We'll get back to that with the sale of Pizza World. Oh, that one's not going to go 10 yards. I think it hit somebody there, but pounced on it right there is Stevie Needham. I think it might have actually hit a North Middlesex guy, but they let it go, and Needham hops on the 50. Getting back to Joe. Louisa and Brandon, lifelong owners of Pizza World, have sold.
Sold?
Yeah, so I don't know. I haven't quite gone back there to see if it's still the same thing. What's the best pizza in town, Joe?
I go back and forth. I like Capri.
Capri, yeah. Capri's good, yep. Even Columbo's is good. Different,
Columbo's
different
good.
Stuff. But if Joe could be any animal, he'd want to be a rhinoceros.
He's out there now. Let's see if he blocks like a rhinoceros. He was in on that scoring play.
Do you know what rhinoceros means? It actually means nose horn, which is ironic, right? Do you want another interesting fact? Do you know what Damari means?
No, I don't.
Nose hair.
Nose hair.
Yeah, it does. No. That may not be corroborated, but I thought I read that in Wikipedia.
Well, I'll go with it.
Listen, we'll find out later. Yeah, we don't let the truth get in the way of a good story. So, nose hair Damari.
Nose hair Damari.
His favorite song, what song would get him pumped up? His response, any song's chill with me. Really?
Chill.
Yeah, chill. Chill him. As you know, Joe, I have an encyclopedic knowledge of pop culture and music. So I'm going to give Joe Gilligan a test right here, right? I want him to look up the song The Floral Dance by Terry Wogan on YouTube. The Floral Dance. I think I may have found the song that's going to refute his claim that any song is chill. Here we go. Handoff up the middle of DeCrescenzo. He drives it for about three or four. The Rockets getting back to the ground and pound there. And we get
ball
Damari.
Control, keep the ball.
We get Damari taking over the spot for the injured Fleming in the backfield. So, yeah, the Floral Dance, it's truly an incredible video and song.
Maybe we have him do that at halftime next week.
You know what I'm going to do? I'm going to see if I can get the audio of the Floral Dance. We'll try to play it before the next game.
All right. It'll be a team theme.
Oh, my God. It's something. It's something to behold. Here we go. It's called second and seven here. We got DeCrescenzo and Damari back. I think that's Pat Dwyer split at the top. Goes to Damari. He cuts back the other way. He's got a little bit of room. Nice move. Spin move. He's still on his feet. And Danny doesn't want to go down. He's probably a yard short of the first, but he had nowhere to go up the seam. Danny bounced it outside and ran that thing off for about a good six yards. He's another guy, too. Danny's he's not the biggest guy out there, but he has got serious speed, and he's got a nose for the hole. And I think Big Dan, Coach Dan, is just waiting for them to get that behemoth Damari size.
Oh, that'll be. I mean, then you're going to have three guys.
We'll have to blame it on the petite Jill Damari and blame it on her for the time being.
He'll get there.
Listen, who needs to get there when you're an athlete like him?
That's
he has
true.
Been a superstar football player on this team for years. And he's a go-to guy for the Rockets. It's third and one here. DiCrescenzo, Damari, split left is Kenyon and Needham in the slot. All right, we got a flag there. Looks like motion. It's got to be on the Rockets. They wouldn't blow it unless there's a timeout.
Yeah, it's a tough one, Tim. You just went third and short to third and...
Gosh, you know what? I didn't see anything there, Joe.
I didn't either.
I saw nothing, and the eagle-eye refs are pushing this thing back 5 yards, and Coach Pollock swaps out the entire O-line for that one. Maybe as a punishment, huh? Don't move or we're going to switch you up. So in comes Troy again with the play. Out comes Pat Duras. It's going to be third and six right here. Here we go. It's third and six for the Rockets in North Middlesex territory. It's back to Pollock and Damari in the backfield. It's going to be a pass. He looks up and he pulls it down. Troy puts his head forward. He wasn't open. He was looking for number eight out there was Trevor Conroy and Stevie Needham underneath in the flat, but Troy didn't see anyone there. They got a big offensive line there. Number 70 is a very big dude. Number 42 are big dudes on the left-hand side here. Those guys get their hands up, and it's tough for Troy to see over them. Troy pulled it down. It's going to be fourth and four, and looks like the Rockets are going to go for it in North Middlesex territory. 5 minutes to go in the third, and they lead 14-6.
Big play here, Tim. Got a first down.
Big play. I see number 65, Anthony Masucci in there. Masucci, he's an all-time classic, too. His favorite food last year, sushi. Wonder if that's still the same. Yeah. Wasabi Masucci, we called him last year. Oh, wow, he pulls him offside. Yikes, they may call that one on us.
Oh, not good.
They do. You know what? The hike actually had, he jumped, and unfortunately the jump made Tice move. He jumped over, and they actually call it on the Rockets on our side. Guy jumped over from North Middlesex. He obviously has the right to get back and get in position. And Tice actually stood up expecting him to come in, and they pushed the Rockets back fourth, another five. It's going to be fourth and nine here. And this is a big play. I'm assuming it's the same play that we were going to call with fourth and five, but we look like
we
Troy is back a little
here.
Bit. We
He's
may
got
have
the
Troy.
Wind to his back.
Looks like Troy is going to try to boot this one. And he
Good
does,
kick.
And it's a great kick by Troy. Beautiful. Almost don't want it to go in the end zone, and it does.
That's
wow.
Okay.
Troy is, listen, I got to talk to him about his kicking prowess, you know, because he booted that one about 50 yards. And fortunate bounce for North Middlesex to get 20 yards back because that could have pinned him very deep. But nice kick, nice move on field position there. And now the Rocket D is going to have to come up. And like we said, these guys get some skill position players who can do something on one play, as we witnessed on the very last one. So let's see what the Rocket D can do here and hold this lead. Here we go. First and 10 here from the 20 for North Middlesex. A classic I formation they've used much of the day today. Handoff up the middle. He busts out right number 51. He's got some room. Nice job. Pulled down from behind. Let's see who that was across the side of the field. Hard to see from here. I think it might have been Damari who came across there. Number 9, Jay Kajander over there, too. So I think it might have been Damari and Kajander. That's going away from us, Joe. My old eyes can't see that far, but it is a gain of about 4. Nice job to pull him down. He looked like he had some room there. Second and 6 here for North Middlesex. Stacked right formation. It's a handoff right up the gut to 24, and he gets ripped down almost immediately, but he gets about 3 or 4. Let's see who's in there making the play. That was Kajander in there again. So run right at Jay, get his hands in there, and Lukey Lorenzo and Dom DiCrescenzo in there to help out too. It's third and short upcoming. Here we go, third and one here right now. Same setup right here, play. He's going to hand it off. Same exact play. He pushes it for the first, or close to the first. He did get pushed back. DiCrescenzo in there, as well as...
They're moving the chains.
Let's see. 44, Stevie Needham was in there. They do get enough for the first, but that's all they needed was 3/4 yard, and they got it. DiCrescenzo and Needham with the stop. But it's first and 10 here from their own 31 upcoming. Here we go, first and 10. 3 minutes and 22 on the clock. I'm not sure if that's exactly accurate, but we'll see what we find out on the clock. Same exact play three times in a row. This time they get stacked up and run down. Ball goes down. Danny Demari in there. That was Dom DiCrescenzo with the big hit there. Demari comes in to clean up. The ball goes squirting out. Beckenhuis in there as well. And that's a pushback right there. So that's the type of rocket we had. It looks like we had a timeout going right now, Joe. So, Joe, you know what was interesting? We asked some of these guys what their favorite, they had a superpower, what they could be, right? I just happened to look at a couple of different things today. So we had Jay Kachander, Joe Gilligan, Coach Joe Gilligan, and Dom DiCrescenzo say that the superpower would be invisibility.
Invisibility.
How about that?
Tough to tackle.
I don't know. It'd be tough to make any of those guys invisible.
That's true.
But how about this? Because we always like to raise the bar here. You know, this isn't community access television, right? There's a moral dilemma about invisibility, Joe. I don't know if you know that. Invisibility gives you the freedom to do what you will, walk in anywhere, take anything you want, go into places you shouldn't go, and do things you shouldn't do. What do you think about that? Is that what they're looking at? Are these bad guys? They want to be invisible and do rotten things? Or
I don't know.
Maybe the question we need to ask is, you know, if you could not get caught doing something, what would you do, right? That's some dark and heady territory for A-League football right here.
Philosophy
question.
You know what I mean?
Well, listen, Joe, we raised the bar here, and there's at least 20 to 24 people who are going to be watching this this thing, and there's a good chance that one of them might know a little bit about moral philosophy.
Or invisibility.
Yes. Yes. You know, what would you do if you were invisible, Joe?
I don't know.
Right?
My wife thinks I am sometimes. Where is he?
I feel invisible sometimes. Yeah, what about us? Here's a handoff up the middle. Counter. Oh, right there, number 51. And who's in there?
Great tackle.
Nice play in there. It was number 52. Mason Dion comes across the middle.
Number eight, Trevor Conroy
comes in to help him out too. So nice looking play. That was the counter. Looked like a very similar counter play to Troy's two big runs, including the touchdown. So it's going to be third and maybe eight coming up here. And very tough territory to think about, four down territory with an entire quarter to go. But we'll have to think about that, what we might do if we're invisible.
All right, I'll get back to you next week.
You'd probably sneak into Capri and start rifling pizzas. I know Coach Dan Demari would do that. That's one of his dream things. Roll out right, he's going to pass it. Pass underneath, number 43 again, pulls it down. Beautiful coverage again by DeRoss. That kid is an athlete, though, and that play has worked well for them three different times today. And, oh, they do move the chains. I didn't think they quite got it, but it's going to be a first down. And three plays, three first downs on that one. And each time, DeRoss has had very good coverage.
It's the same last week, Tim. He had great coverage all last week. Waiting for an interception from him this year.
Yeah, give the quarterback credit, too. He put it right on the spot each time. And as you see what happens when he throws it behind him, Evan Tice made that play. He threw it just a little bit behind this guy, and Tice hopped up and scooped that one before the half, which was a huge play for the Rockets. Back to the I formation. Oh, they run into each other, but he hands off to 51, and he gets crunched. He sort of ran into his own guy and then got picked up. Oh, it looks like Kajander's hurt a little bit there, but in there was number, let's see who else is in there, number 15, Adam Diemer in there, gave him a stick too. So he sort of bumped into his own guy and then got pushed back by Diemer and Kajander. It's going to be second and 11 coming up. Here we go, second and 11 for North Middlesex. Number 43 split right. That's an inside handoff to him, and he's got a huge hole. Oh, and he gets crunched by Kajander coming back in. He was looking at who was on him closely. 52 was right in there. That was Mason Dion pursuing him. Kajander sheds his tackler and puts a serious lick on him. He earned 4 yards, but it was 4 yards the hard way there. He's feeling that one right now. That rung his bell, and they're circling the wagons right now over at the North Middlesex side.
I think we have the end of the third quarter, Tim.
Could be the end. It looks like they may be switching sides coming up. We'll take a look.
Go.
Hey, there's Joe Gilligan Sr. here. We asked the coaches to fill out some things, too. And you know what Joe's favorite food is? Bacon.
Bacon.
Yeah. Specifically,
bacon ice cream?
No, specifically, I think it was bacon, stuffed bacon wrapped in bacon. Right?
A little bit of bacon.
Yeah, you just look at him smiling right now. He's thinking of bacon right now, right there. He's like, oh, I'll get some water.
It's a good week for Joe because the Patriots aren't playing right now.
Oh, my gosh. Joe is, he's one of those guys, right? I'm going to tape the Patriots and don't let anyone in the real world contact me until I've seen them.
Had earmuffs on the whole last week.
Yeah. Well, ironically, Joe would also like Bill Belichick to be president. True story. He wrote that one. The place he most wanted to visit, Ireland. I was there last week, buddy.
How was it?
Well, it was great, but I'm not allowed to go back for another 7 years.
That's okay.
Legal reasons. I could give Joe some tips to try to avoid those type of problems when he goes there.
He probably knows what they are. In fact, he's probably not allowed back for 7 years.
All right, here we go. We're getting back to the Rockets here. Man, it is a beautiful day. The wind calmed down just for us, Joe. They calmed down for us while we're up here in the booth. And it's going to be third and call it eight here. Big play for the Rockets D because this is a tough time. We're in fourth. Here, inside handoff. He's got some room. Oh! He runs into Dion, bowls him over for the first down. He had a head of steam, but Mason right in there to give him a stick. Stevie Needham in there, Damari as well. But that guy had a big head of steam and drove it for the first down and into Rocket territory. So that's a huge play for North Middlesex to keep this thing going. Nine and a half minutes left in the game. They're trailing by eight. I'm going to ask a lot of this Rocket defense right now. Maybe some... Maybe a nice little pick or a nice little fumble right here up the middle. Let's see if that defensive line can get in there. Stack type formation. He's going to inside hand off at a 43 again. Oh, he cuts out of this. Kajander again. Not fooled again on that play. And that kid's a great athlete. Exactly. Great play by Jay to stay home. Forced him out, pushed him back 5 yards. And, you know, one move on Jay, if he's not there to close on him, and that kid's got nothing but daylight on him. We know he's got wheels, 43. So beautiful play on two separate occasions on Kajander on that play. That's what we're talking about, that big line. DiCrescenzo, Lorenza, Kajander, O'Connor.
Deamer,
15. Those guys are some big bodies in there. And they are playing well. Second and call it 13 from midfield. It's going to be a keeper. He's going to pass. It's underneath. Oh, boy. Pat Duros. That's the one we almost talked about. The pressure was big. Big pressure from Adam Deamer in there. Kajander in number 52 in there as well was Mason Dion. The beast Dion. Calling Mason's name a bunch of times today. And that pressure was too much. He had to get away from it. And Pat Duros almost got his hands on it. Coach Pollock giving a little bit of on-field instruction here to Evan Tice. Because they call timeout right here at 3rd and 15. You might be looking for another pass play, and I think coach is trying to coach that one up. That very effective pass play to 43 underneath might be on the docket for North Middlesex coming up. But you wonder if it's four down territory here. At midfield, it's a tough call to make, but they're trailing by eight, and we'll see what's coming up next. All right, here we go. It's going to be 3rd and 13 here. Coach Ritchie imploring this defense to – step it up right here. Big play in motion, number 24. It's going to be a pass play underneath. Same play we've seen three times, and great coverage right there by Tice. You know, they've used that play three times, and guess what? You can't do it a fourth time. Yeah. Great play by Tice right there to get in there. He said spy number 43, and now it's fourth down here, and this is a very, very big play with 8 minutes to go. The Rockets stopped them here. They could eventually start doing some ball control and eat up some clock here in the fourth quarter. But very big play here. They have the players to convert, though, too.
They converted the ball well. Our coverage has been great all day, but when you get guys in the open like that, anything can happen.
Let's see if Coach has some – they're spying this guy. They're pointing the number 43, saying he's the guy to watch. It's an inside handoff to 43. This time he cuts it up. Nice play again right there, and I think it was – let's see who's in there. Of course, Jay Kajander again.
And like 44 Stephen Needham.
44 Stephen Needham
Adam
is there.
Deamer.
Forced him upside, but that's going to turn over on downs.
And 10 Rockets.
And there we go. Rockets take over on downs. Great, great defensive stop right there for the boys. Nice job. Everyone's pumped up over there. Jay Kajander having a monster game, especially hurt on that series of downs. So, great job.
I think they might go somewhere else, Tim. That defense will be ready.
All right, here we go. Let's see what we got in the backfield here. It looks like Damari and DiCrescenzo back. Split left is Tice. Oh, it's a high snap over Darmy's head. and he tarts right back up and bowls it almost back to the original line of scrimmage. But a high snap over Dom's head. He did a good job. Lucky bounce to pop right up to him. And it's a loss of 2 yards. It could have been a loss of 20. And the Rockets are going to regroup and try it again. I call it second and 13 here after the bad snap. Better one there. It goes directly to Damari. He looks for the hole. It closes very quickly on him. Nice play by number 54 from North Middlesex. Number 10 in there too. But Danny saw the hole and it closed very quickly. And for no gain, we're going to be looking at third and 12 here at the Rockets 40. Here we go. Third down here. So we're talking off camera. We want to eat up some clock here. Very stacked, heavy left formation. Look for them just to follow this. And they go right. They stack heavy left. They put Domi Crescent up the middle. And Domi breaks it. And he's going to run away. He might get caught. Let's see. He does get caught from behind. Did the ball go down? Did he go down? It looks like he's down. I didn't know if he lost the ball at the end.
No, it's going to be
the Rockets ball. What a play. What a play by Di Crescenzo. They stack everyone heavy left. He goes right, and he finds a seam and rushes it right up the middle. He's a big dude rumbling down there, too.
No one wants to tackle him, Tim, and he's fast once he gets out there.
Wow.
Good combination.
Huge play. They don't like seeing Di Crescenzo with the ball bearing down on him, and that is a huge conversion right there with third and very long. And now the Rockets are just outside the 10-yard line. Almost, say, call it. They can get it. They can get a first down.
Which I want actually, a touchdown, Tim. A little greedy.
You're getting a little fired up here, Joe.
I'm fired up.
All right, jeez, you got to go home and take a nap. All right, here we go.
It's that time.
It looks like Kajander in the backfield. He's gonna follow Jay. Oh, that's Damari cuts back. Oh boy, Jay and Damari goes in. How about they put Jay Kajander in the backfield? He's hitting everybody in sight on defense. They put him in the backfield. He not only hits the first guy going in, Damari cuts back. He turns around and hits another guy.
Why not?
And he goes in for the score. So here I am pumping up the blocker. Meanwhile, Danny Damari scoring a touchdown here. So beautiful play by the Rockets. And that's some much-needed breathing room right here because this is a tougher game than the score might indicate right now.
Absolutely.
But that's a huge score for the Rockets. Plenty of time, and
you can
bet on the ensuing kickoff that the Rockets coaching staff is going to be telling these guys to stay in their lanes. Here we go for the extra point here. Kajander and Di Crescenzo in the backfield. Right to Domi up the middle. He puts his head down and bowls it. Does he get himself in? I think he does.
No signal.
And he does.
Yes, he does.
Yep. So Di Crescenzo puts the head down, bowls through his own offensive lineman and a couple of their defensive linemen for the extra point. And those are big points right here, too, to put this thing beyond what is, you know, two scores for North Middlesex. But let's take a quick look. Let's take a quick look at what this kickoff's going to bring us, Joe. The last one didn't work out well for the Rockets. This is a play you may see Foxy get coached up here to not kick it away. Let's squib that thing right up the middle, not let one of these big skill position guys get it, and make him run the clock out. So let's see what the coaching staff has in mind for this one. Brendan Fox, first-year player here, and he has been a good one. And he does kick it away. He lets it go. Oh, tough bounce. Number 10 picks it up, and beautiful play right over there. It looked like maybe Damari over there. He runs in for the touchdown and comes in and closes on that guy. It was a unfortunate bounce for North Middlesex, but Damari closed on that guy quickly. He didn't have a chance. So nice job there by the Rockets not to allow the run back. It's going to be first and 10 for North Middlesex from just inside their own 40. Here we go, first down here. Big test for we got to get another guy out here. There's two guys wide open. Needham and Tice there. He's going to throw the ball across the middle. Oh, boy, Damari gets his hands up, almost pulls it down. Listen, Danny Damari is saying, I want to make every play from
every
here on
play.
Out. Every
well,
play. He's getting very
okay
selfish, very selfish.
That's okay.
It's sort of like his father on the buffet line.
Yeah.
I mean, very selfish.
Well, what's Danny Damari Sr.'s favorite food?
I think it's meatball wrap meatballs.
Meatball wrap
yeah.
meatballs.
Yeah.
I could
be wrong. I think we said that Damari meant nose hair. I think it means meatball eating behemoth. That's what I think it means. Yeah. We'll have to confirm that. We probably won't confirm it, though,
no,
for next year now.
We got other things to do, Tim.
Yeah, very busy after this. All right, so here we go. Taking a long time in the huddle here. Damari almost pops up with that one. That would have ended it for sure. Two guys look like another passing down here. It's going to be cross middle. Oh, boy. Good. Oh, and there it is. He overthrows the ball right there. Pat DeRoss, the one you said he was going to do. You called it earlier that DeRoss was going to pull one down, and he did. He's played beautifully defensively all game today. Gets a little bit of air under it right into DeRoss's hands. He picks it up, takes it back another 20 yards, and there you go. Beautiful play by Pat DeRoss right there. And that's going to be that could be just about enough with 5 minutes to go here.
Just grind it out here, Tim.
I think it's possible that it might be less time than what's on the clock up there, but we'll find out soon enough. And what a play by DeRoss. You predicted it. DeRoss is having a big game.
So well. It's just
it didn't show on the stat sheet, and it finally did right there. So Pat made a big turnover right now. Let's see who's in the backfield here. Looks like Damari following Beckenhuis. Oh, boy. I told you he wants to do it all. And there goes Damari for another one. He was actually mad that Pat DeRoss made a play in between his five unbelievable plays in a row.
That's what he was talking to him about. I thought it was a good catch. He probably
He got right in DeRoss's face and said, that was my play.
Yeah.
Right? So, oh, my gosh. What a play by Damari. I tell you, the first half, the Troy Pollack story offensively, right? Second half, we get Damari tearing it up. And more importantly, both line play has been tremendous.
Oh, yes.
Tremendous on both sides here. I think I saw a nice little block right over the top there. Was Max Ramos in there on guard. Made a nice play. Kajander follows, and he looks like he's in for the extra point, too. So Rockets are going to make this thing 28-6. Put a little distance between them and North Middlesex. I think they're wearing them down now. But
I think Giancarlo Musto opened that hole.
Musto. The Worm?
The Worm. G.
Yeah. G. The Worm. Well, listen, maybe he has a different nickname. A couple of years ago, he was the Worm.
The Worm, right.
But he could actually do the Worm no one's business.
It is entertaining. We're going to have him do that at halftime.
You know what? For the halftime entertainment of the millions watching at home, we're going to have the Worm do his Worm. Let's see if we – of course, once again, we're too late to have the girls do their cheer. They just did it.
We need a third person on the payroll, Tim.
Well, my contract is only in six figures with RCTV, and so they tightened the belt this year from last year.
Understandably.
And we have a visitor up in the booth here, and it's my daughter, Grace O'Connor. We're calling her over here. Grace is very, very talkative, so she's going to want to get on here. Hello, Grace. Grace is joining us. Big win here, right? The Rockets are doing a great job. Looks like Foxy's going to kick away again.
Comfortable lead. Now
Adam Deemer, Zach Kenyon, Jonathan Grady, Stevie Needham, Kajander on this side. Sean Beckenhuis. Mason Dion on the others. Here we go. Here's Foxy kicking it away. Nice boot by Foxy. Oh, nice bounce there, too. Oh, he's touched the ball. That's a live ball. Good job just
smart
to pounce on it there.
Yeah,
right
smart.
On top of him is Kajander, and Jonathan Grady was right in his face, too. So with just under 2 minutes to go here, 28-6, North Middlesex is going to try to pull a rabbit out of their hat, but I don't think there's enough time in the day for them to get back in this one. Here we go. It's first down for North Middlesex. You might see them try to pull a few rabbits out of the hat here. It's going to be another pass up the middle. Oh, he throws it down. I think we might see a call there. It looked like Musto, the Worm, had actually tried doing the Worm on top of that receiver's back. It might be a penalty there.
That would be not legal.
Well, guess what? If you've seen him do the Worm, many people say that's not legal either. You know what I'm saying? Or barely legal. So Musto gets... runs into the receiver, and they call a penalty. It's going to be first down here for North Middlesex. Calling in the play. In goes Lynchy right over the nose. Big Dave Lynch, another classic Lynchy. Number 10, wearing a typical quarterback's number. You don't want to see Lynchy bearing down on you either. It's going to be a keeper. He's going to try to roll this thing. Throws it across the middle. Great play. Great catch by number 42. once again, well covered. He threw it right in the seam there. So they get some nice plays out of that sort of halfback option. You know, they could read option where they could keep it himself or throw it. He actually threw that one behind him, looking like John Elway back in the days, rolling out left and throwing across right. So it looks like we might be getting close. Timeout here on the field with probably just over a minute to go here with the Rockets who have this one in hand. Here we go. It's second and three here for North Middlesex. Tell you, Joe, they're dressed up like the Boise State Cowboys. I don't know if you know that home field. Looks like it's going to be a pass here across the middle. Throws it underneath. Oh, right there, number 71. Pat Dwyer almost jumps it. Pat does a great job to jump the route, almost pulled it in.
I think I might have missed it on the camera. His mother's going to kill me.
Of course, oh. Right? Pat gets in there, makes a great defensive play, and you're not paying attention.
It wasn't. Jeez.
Beautiful play by Pat to jump that route, and he almost stole it. I'd like to see him rumbling 35 yards for a touchdown. How would have been something.
It's a flash.
So Boise State's home field, their turf, AstroTurf, is blue.
Yeah, they call them the Smurf.
Yeah, well, listen, I was watching, true story, I was watching a game of theirs 10 years ago, and I changed the color of my TV to make it green because I thought my TV was all messed up. It took me 45 minutes to get it back. All right, handoff right up the middle, number 51. He cuts back. There's number 8 over there is Trev Conroy. He's still on his feet, though. Wow, big run here. And looks like number 51, that's Giancarlo Musto, pushes him out.
Giancarlo's stepping up here.
The worm got mad about running into that guy and getting called, the flag thrown on him, and he puts a lick on him there. But that's a big run right there for North Middlesex. Going to be first down in Rocket territory, but we got to be getting down close to the end of the game here.
Not much clock, and going out of bounds helped them. I think they only have one timeout left here.
Here we go. It's first down. Rocket 43, I formation. Two guys swung out right. Look for a pass again. He's going to pull it in. He throws it out. He's wide open, number 43, and he just overthrows him. This time, Dwyer bit on the pump fake, and number 43 was out there. And fortunate for the Rockets, a little bit thrown too far. But nonetheless, incomplete pass. Second down here, and we're under a minute to go. All right, here we go. It's second down here. The incomplete pass. Number 43 was wide open there. Just overthrew him. It's going to be inside handoff to 43. He's got a lot of room there. Out there, number 8 is over there. Trevor Conroy just forces him out. 41, Sean Beckney, he's over there too. But we've seen that play work to some good effect for North Middlesex until they put Kajander out there because Jay just ate up that play all night long.
He has stayed home all day. Like he didn't get out of bounds, Tim. The clock is rolling.
I think we can see the referees looking at it. He may be blowing a whistle right here and calling the game. And that's it. That's the game. And wow.
That's a big win. That's a good team they just beat. Listen, 2 weeks in a row.
Very, very good team, North Middlesex, today. And the Rockets fortunate to break away because 28-6, it was a lot tighter game than that.
I agree.
Had some very, very good players on that other side. But, you know, credit some of the big names we heard today early on defensively was, you know, Danny O'Connor, Dom DiCrescenzo. Later on defensively, Kajander, Damari. Big plays.
Damari owned the fourth quarter.
He was, like I said, he was mad at Pat Duras making a play. Evan Tice, another guy defensively. Huge interception. And he pulled a guy down from behind was great. And early on, it was the Fleming guy, DiCrescenzo show, too. That was the pound game. And then they busted it out with Troy Pollock. Two huge touchdown runs early. So they spread out a lot of the talent. And then, you know, without calling individual names, that offensive and defensive line were awesome.
Yeah, most of the game. Defense has been predominant all year, and they continued that today.
We're hoping right now, for our sake, that Lucas Fleming is able to shake off that ankle injury because we need him next week. I think we're up at Drake It next week, Joe.
Another
and that
good
is
team.
A big grudge match for us. We lost during the regular season 7-6 in a very tightly held game, and we got run off the field by the same team in the playoffs.
Only team that beat them last year.
Only team that beat our Rockets last year. We got them next week, and that's going to be an awesome one up in Draket. Love to see those guys. I know the Rockets have some revenge on their mind. So, hey, Joe, great to be back, my friend.
Good to have you
back.
You
did a nice job, and we'll shake off the rust up here and make some things going later.
Rust.
All right, see you, Joe. Take care. We'll see you next week.